if you're scrolling through Facebook or Instagram and things look a little different, you've probably been included in a recent ban on Canadian news. The weeks-long pilot from Meta will affect up to 5% of users here, about 1.2 million people, as the company looks to potentially suspend it permanently.
I think that would probably be bad for everybody. That's a bad outcome for people, for the internet, and for that matter, for publishers who are losing an audience this way.
Meta's move is the latest development in a cold war between tech titans and the federal government over a controversial piece of legislation, Bill C-18. It would require internet giants to compensate news outlets for posting their work. Meta made the same ban in Australia and California over similar laws. Google did a trial ban for Canada too, but the Canadian government isn't backing down.
I see it as a threat. I see it as intimidation. You have a big, you know, tech giant. Very rich, very powerful, big lawyers coming to a country, sovereign country, Canada, and telling the lawmakers and the, you know, senators, MPs, I don't like what you're doing. If you don't do what I do, what I like, I'm pulling out of the country. And I find that unacceptable.
If you're an affected user, you won't be able to share news articles or even see them, nor can you access the pages of media outlets. They can continue to post, but some of it won't be viewable in Canada. Media experts are concerned the ban fuels the spread of misinformation and could strand key information while the country is facing devastating wildfires. The Conservative Party says this standoff shouldn't be happening.
I don't believe that either big tech or big government should censor what people see and say online.
Bill C-18 is currently before the Senate, and the federal government hopes to have it wrapped up before Parliament breaks for the summer. Elise Von Scheel, CBC News, Calgary.